the tweet that you sent out yesterday. I think your fans and a lot of people who follow you want to know a little more. Would you like to shed some light?
Was it really cryptic?
It was very cryptic indeed.
I'm really surprised because I went through my timeline and I found it had a lot of quote tweets and retweets. If people didn't understand, I don't know what on earth they were doing, quote tweeting and retweeting it. Look, I think it's very, very simple. I've always wanted to talk about this at some stage, but I thought it was very, very pertinent because if you can, you, I mean, if some of us went to a shop and you want to buy a product, I'll just ask you a question, Rika. What do you do if somebody introduces new toothpaste or soap or something?
Well, I actually evaluate it. I mean, I am a person who Googles a lot, and I kind of look at it before buying. I make my own decision. Yeah, I don't take
Correct.
Decisions.
But you would obviously, you would obviously buy it and then decide whether you like it or not, right?
Not necessarily. I could probably evaluate even before buying.
Oh, that's wonderful to know because that's exactly what I want people to do. Because these are at least products. You can at the most you can go wrong by buying them and finding out they're bad or good. But I think with respect to thoughts being put across and planted to people is something that's really, I find it extremely hilarious and heinous to a point where you have a thought process and you want everybody to follow that and want to think that and also, you know, make it a conditioning. Because with thoughts, what happens is you condition people to believing in a certain way. So you watch a match, you watch India win the game. At most, everybody's saying, hey, I'm happy India won the game. It's a great feeling. But you don't want people to go back home and say, India is not winning the game. Yeah, it's the pitch that's winning the game. So that's not what I want people to do. And I know anyway, that's going to come up. And these are conditioning that's happening. And it's happened for a long, long time. When are we even going to wake up to it? I think it's important that people sell things, but we must know what we must buy.
Ex-cricketers from 80s or 90s, they have their own set of agendas. They speak what they feel like. But does it hurt when there is a Yuvraj Singh with whom you have shared the dressing room? He can just pick up a call and speak to you. But the way they say 800 wickets, 1500 wickets, saying things based on probably hypothetical calculations, does it hurt you? Because these are people who have played with you. They were in the part of the dressing room. They're not like a fan on the street when they comment like that.
Okay. The reason behind my tweets were definitely not in context with anybody in particular. And when I read Yuvraj's tweet, I actually didn't get affected at all, to be honest, because I didn't find like he was, you know, telling us anything or trying to suggest or anything. It just felt like a really, really plain tweet of saying these people were good and whatever, however you want to perceive it. But for me, the state of mind I am in right now, I didn't find it to be, you know, anything wrong or anything, you know, what to say, an agenda driven or nothing like that. I know Yuvipa for a very, very long time and I have the utmost respect for him. But with respect to your agenda driven thoughts and all that, this is exactly what my tweets were meaning. Some of us or some people amongst us tend to buy the stuff that people sell. And I do not know the reason behind why certain people sell certain things, but it's clear. It's just a perception of what happens. For me, I want to protect, or at least I want to try and put it out there that people who know me or who are watching me talk at least realize that without their knowledge, they are actually being hypnotized to believing what they are buying. There have been some people who messaged me and said match is finished in 2 days, and what about all the three ping pong test matches that we played? Everything is ended within 3 day time. And I do not want to know what to say because when somebody just throws an opinion out there about a surface and having had to play the game, unfortunately, maybe they have not played the ping ball test matches. So they do not understand this facet of the game. But my angst against the whole thing is the fact that when people say something, there are so many other people who are watching the same picture, but are not able to paint a different one compared to somebody who's driving a certain case and selling a certain case to us. And this needs to stop.
You expect or you hope for a similar surface for the next test match?
I have a question back. What is a good cricket surface?
Well, I get it. I mean, I'm the one asking the question, but I would think that it offers,
because it offers an even contest
between bat and ball.
Yes, of course. The bowler was in the game. The batsman needs to bat well to get runs. There is absolutely no question about it. What makes a good surface? Who defines this? Seam on the first day, then bat well, then spin on the last 2 days? Come on. who makes all these rules? We need to get over it and not talk about whatever picture we want to paint. And if you're asking whether it's a good test surface, I don't see any of the team, any of the players coming in from England having an issue with the surface. They want to improve. They look like they want to have to have a contest. Is it the players and the people who are reporting back that want their players to not compete and complain about the pitches? Because we've never done that in any of the tours.
Okay. And in that case, are you hoping for a similar surface in the next test match?
It depends on what you're hoping for. We hope for a good cricket match.
I think most people would hope for a good cricket match.
Of course, that's what you should be hoping for, not about the surface. Has there been any instance where the surface has been spoken about when any other place, any other country we played games in? It is, I don't know if we find it very, very funny that when they speak about the surface, it immediately gets quoted all over in our press. And that is the issue here, because there have been instances when we went to New Zealand, both tests got over within 5 days, a total of 5 days for two test matches. And now nobody quoted it. There is a video that's doing the rounds where Virat in South Africa is saying, I am not here to talk about the pitch and I'm not comforting my boys with regards to that. And that is how we've been taught to play cricket. And I don't know why we indulge such thoughts and, you know, promote such thoughts. And that's why I say, let them sell it. Buying is always our choice.